ready to build the racking system for some aquariums that I simply don't have just yet. If you guys remember though, we are building two racks to hold 6 40-gallon aquariums. Three here, three here. Hopefully it's going to fit. By my measurements, it's gonna be tight, but I think it's gonna work. Look at all this. This isn't even a lot of wood, and that's gonna build two racks. I might beef them up a little bit, but this is just like the skeleton to it. I don't have the aquariums just yet, but you guys will remember that a lot of these aquariums are run by 40-gallon breeder tanks built into sumps. I did this a little while ago. So basically I just took the measurements and went by that. I don't need the physical tanks here because I already kind of have them. The new tanks come in a couple of days. Now, because these are only 40-gallon aquariums, they're not going to be that heavy. I decided I'd go with some 2x3s, an inch smaller than a 2x4, just to save on space. This is only a 3-foot span as well, so I don't really need that much support. A 40-gallon aquarium, once full, only weighs around 400 pounds, and this rack is going to be able to support over 4 times the total of the 3 on each one. Bottom line is this, I made sure we did straight cuts as well. This is just gonna go together kind of weird, but actually simple. Let me just show you how to do the first one. So check this out. You guys will remember these as being like the bottom piece where the tank actually sits on, but you'll also notice that it's kind of butt out a little bit on each end. Give me a second. If I measured and cut all this correctly, the rest is gonna be easy. I'm just gonna put one together so we can better explain it. Okay. We have the base, these are the risers or the guides that actually set the height of the entire rack or stand when you're building a stand. So now you're getting a better idea. The tanks are going to go on the bottom four and the supports and risers are going on the outside as opposed to the inside like we would with a typical tank like this one here that we just built. For example, the base of it runs the entire perimeter of the tank, whereas on the new one, all of this stuff is gonna be put to the outside so we can get a tank in here, and a tank up top. Now the actual support system, what the tanks are actually going to rest on. They're gonna be 24 inches in space in between each tank. The tanks are 17 inches tall, gives me about 7 or 8 inches above and below the tanks. I figured that should be enough. And I think it's now starting to kind of make sense for a lot of you that didn't understand it at first. Almost forgot how I put this together. Yeah, this is a fantastic design, space saving, it's gonna be strong, no problems whatsoever. This isn't even screwed in, I weigh almost 200 pounds, and this isn't going anywhere. The tanks filled will be 400 on each thing. Each one of these upright supports will support 600 pounds individually, 6, 12, 18, 2400 pounds. That's twice as much as I need. Plus the screws having a shearing strength of about 50 pounds a piece, 3 screws on each post, times whatever, it's thousands of pounds of support. Nothing at all to worry about. Gonna give you guys a better look, a better idea of what's actually being supported. For example, well, when the tank goes on this one, the floor is actually supporting it. Weight goes through the wood, transfers to the concrete. This is a 16 inch foundation, not going anywhere. Tank is sitting on this one, all the weight is transferred to an actual upright. It's not put on the screws here, it's transferred through this entire length here, this entire run, and the weight goes through here, transferred down to the bottom again, and that's what we want to keep going with. I don't think it looks that bad. In fact, I think it looks pretty darn awesome if you ask me. I think from the sides, it does not look that appealing because, you know, there's kind of like a gap going down the sides, but you do look at it from this angle. And of course, once we get some paint on this, it's gonna look absolutely fantastic. That said, there's a couple of things we're gonna point out. One, you're probably wondering why there's no center braces. Just didn't decide to add them. With such a short span, I'm not going to anticipate any bowing. Plus, on a glass aquarium, the 40-gallon breeders that I'm getting, they have a lip that is goes around the perimeter. No glass actually touches it, and nothing goes in the center, so there's nothing to actually support. You guys will see once we add the tanks on there. So this is essentially done. I'm gonna go ahead and put the next one together. Well, they're done, and I think they look really good. I went ahead and gave them a quick coat of black paint. Obviously, I don't know if this is going to be like, you know, the end look or whatever, but I do think it looks pretty good as is right now. Once we get the aquariums actually in place, I'll figure out if I want to wrap it in or anything, or give them canopies or lids, you know, whatever the case might be. They also need to be leveled out. The floor in here is not that level at all, so a lot of the times it'll make the stands look a little wonky until I do level them. But as for over here, I will be blocking off access over to this way, which is just has the two filters back there. But I never use, not once, these stairs. So I'm ripping these stairs out and giving myself access to completely all the way around, which means that blocking it off over here isn't going to be that big of a deal. In fact, I kind of like having it like this. We'll see what it looks like once we get the tanks in there, though. Of course, let me know what you guys think of the look of this. Now, of course, what I wanted to also do was include the cost. And that's not actually something I do all the time. Sometimes I'll include total cost at the end, et cetera, et cetera. But for this one, I know lots of people, and I even asked you guys in the last video, what does it usually cost for you to set up a 40 gallon? And the responses were varied. Usually averaging around $10 a gallon, making it about 400 bucks. So if I were to use that math, 4, 8, 12, 16, 20, it should cost me $2,400 to set this up, but it's not even gonna cost me half that. The thing is, when you set up these racking systems, you save a tremendous amount of money, because a lot of the times you only spend what it costs to build one stand. The filtration is usually all linked, or you're running it off one pump, etc. We'll see as this series kind of progresses how I'm able to set all this up for probably less than $1,000. These two racks cost $120 total, and that is on the higher end in my opinion, because I simply overbought supplies. For example, I bought way too much paint, but it didn't go to waste. I did repaint all of the stands, just gave them a fresh update, painted the top of the 2000 as well as the viewing, like the ledge within it, just because it's gonna be a month or two before we actually work on this and renovate that. And in the meantime, well, I got all this extra paint, and we also repainted the stand on the 375 gallons. So everything got a fresh coat, and I still got a tremendous amount left. I also overbought on the 2x3s. I have two left extra. I could probably build something out of that. I always save a lot of my extra materials and use it in the future. So I got I literally bought a gallon of paint for this. I always overbuy paint or underbuy it. I never calculate it properly at all. Go figure, like I said, a gallon of paint for that little thing. But I'd rather have too much than not enough. Anyway, so that is the racking system. Showed you guys how I did it. It's a pretty decent design. I think many of you guys will be able to use it, run with it, make some changes, do whatever you want there. This is gonna be great for 40-gallon tanks. I'd probably build this for anything up to 3-foot-long tanks, or maybe even 4-foot-long. I could use this design. I am thinking about adding some braces, some diagonal braces to the back, but I don't know if I'm wrapping it yet, so I'm gonna get the 40-gallon breeders in there before I add any additional bracing. But for 120 bucks, we're off to a good start. If you guys wanna see the rest of this series, you're not subscribed to this channel yet, I highly suggest you do. You're not gonna wanna miss what we end up doing with these.